We've got a nice roll of 19mm PVC hose. And some copper tubing. So they're the main parts, obviously. With the copper tubing, I've done a little bit of research. And I want to use 15mm compression fittings. Just like that one. The reason I want to use the 15mm compression fittings is, one, they're cheap. I want to make this build as cheap as I can. The thread on them is half inch BSP, which fits most things that I've got already. From China, ages and ages ago, I got a hose lock type fitted brass, a half inch BSP thread on. So that screws straight onto that fitting. That's why I've gone for the 15mm. It's not too bad on size. So you get your 15mm and then it's slightly reduced for the middle. So, as I've gone for these fittings, the pipe, the outside pipe I'm going to put onto the threaded part there, because it's threaded, I've chosen a 19mm internal diameter hose, so it'll screw onto there. That was my initial thought. The problem is, because it's threaded, there's a good chance the water's going to follow the threads and leak. I've got some Jubilee clips to hold it on. It's also not huge length thread. So what I'm going to do is put some like 2-pack water sealant plumbing, I don't know what you call it really, like filler, onto them threads, let it dry, give it a quick sand so it's nice and clear, sort of smooth, then I'll put the pipe on and that should give it, the mating surface should be smooth then. And then hopefully with the Jubilee clip and a little bit of resistance you've got from the back of the thread, should hold the tube on there, or hose on there fine. That's the theory anyway. Obviously we don't know until we do all these things. So a lot of people have used, I've noticed recently, have used the external type fittings. So not using the 15mm compression, the internal thread is still half inch BSP, and then they put insert into that. So that's going to be at the end of the wall chiller. So we're going to have water goes, cold water goes in the top from a hose, and then it will go around the outside of the counterflow chiller. So the 8mm or copper pipe I've chosen is 8mm, so that will go through the middle. There's plenty of room for that. The reason I've chosen the 8mm copper, here there's 10 metres. I was trying to look and find out how much the length of the counterflow chiller you want to be most efficient. The copper comes in 10 metres, I think I could find 25 metres as well. I don't want to join it, I don't want it to be unrealistically large, because I think 10 metres is going to be fine for heat transfer. The reason I've chosen the 8mm rather than the 10, the 10mm would still go through this compression fitting, 10mm pipe inside the 19mm tube or internal diameter tube gives kind of an equal, roughly an equal amount of water flowing through it to water flowing through it. It's similar. So the heat transfer hopefully will work, but as we've experienced this summer in England, it's been really warm. Groundwater's really warm coming out the tap. I think I've recorded about 18 degrees at one point. So there's not a lot of differential when we want to get it down to sort of 19 degrees for pitching temperature. So I'm hoping by using the 15mm copper tube, because it's the internal internal of it is 6mm, that's going to take a long time for the water to go through that, and there's going to be a lot of surface area compared to the amount of water that's in there to chill. So we know with the counterflow, we put our water in one mop side and we go, let's say, clockwise, and then our cooling water coming from the opposite side and flowing the opposite direction. So as the water leaves the water chiller, it's coming in contact with the coldest water, so that's straight from the mains. As it starts its journey through the water chiller, straight from the boil kettle, it's got the warmest side water, and that way it's most efficient. Well, it's clever people have worked that out. To increase the surface area on here and create some turbulence in the water, which I understand will help heat transfer, I've got some, it's about 1.3mm copper wire. It isn't in fact complete copper, it's copper coated. The inside, I think, is an alloy of some sort, but lots of manufacturers now tend not to use copper in certain things. This is from coaxial cable. It's like aerial cable, it's just a heavy duty version. So I had some of that, so I stripped it down just to get the centre out of it, the conductor. So it's copper coated, so it's not going to corrode, etc. So the only point that we get anything, the material is quite inert, we just put a lump of silver at the end to seal that, just to make sure. I'm going to wrap that around the copper tube. This is quite, just wants to go straight really, so this is going to be fun when we wrap it around. So the first thing I'm going to do is get everything ready, straighten out the copper tube, then I'm going to wrap this around in a spiral, and then we're going to attempt to put it through the hose. So let's get on with it. The weather's nice. Just so I don't damage it, I'm just going to lay it on so it's flat. It's a nice soft copper tube. So it should unravel quite well. Stop wrapping the wire around first and then solder it. But I'm thinking this stuff's quite springy and it's going to go everywhere, so if I start with a soldered point, it's fixed on there, and then I can start spiraling the wire around. Just going to put some gloves on. So catch my hands on stuff. thinking this is going to be a nightmare. So far it's not going too bad. I'll get my glove out. I'm thinking if I keep the wire coiled, I can even turn it round what I'm doing. I don't think it's overly necessary to put the this spire around, but it will add to the water turbulence. Obviously this side doesn't come in contact with the water at all, so it's not going to create any hygiene problems. Around like that. Don't know whether I'm gonna. Okay, I can't move it too much once it's on. So I have to be fairly neat the way I put it round, I think. Not too bad. I'll probably stop there and I'll solder this next piece. Still. Oh, my candle's gone out. I haven't got a match, so I've got to go to the hob, light the candle, then come out and light this, because this blows out on the way up. It's a pain, but we'll get there. Well, I managed to do that. Apologise about the noise, but a neighbour's doing some sanding or something. Pain in the arse. It took a little bit longer than expected, as most of these things do, but I've managed to get the copper wire around the copper tube. So let's stand out of the way. There's the copper wire, copper tube going all the way down. So what I've got to do now is cut the hose, probably a little bit longer than I want, and then I'm going to try and feed the copper tube through the hose. That's going to be a pain. I've seen it done before, and they seem to have got their copper tube a little bit straighter than me. I'm struggling a bit with that, but I hope it'll work. What other people I've seen done is put a bit of washing up liquid down the tube with some water, which obviously offers a little bit of lubrication as it goes down. So hopefully that'll work. I'll probably try that straight away. Probably won't even try it without any washing up liquid in it. So here we go. Okay, what I've got now is the hose is laid next to the copper tube. I've got some water and a bit of washing up liquid. I'm going to stand at this end, maybe, because it's higher. Pour the washing up liquid down the tube and pour some water and alternate that a little bit until it comes out the far end. Hopefully that way it will give it a little bit of lubrication. Then I can coil up the tube, hose, go down the far end and then try and feed it through. I've got the longest point I've got, which is probably 10-12 metres, so I'm not going to be able to lay it out in length next to it. Following each other like 20 metres and then try and do it. This might be a bit tricky. Probably best if I coil the hose up from that end and then make
maybe try and feed it from that. Right, last probably 2 meters. Success. We've got the copper pipe into the hose. It's drawn in, I think, because it's sort of 19 mil and the copper pipe's 8. So 10, you probably add in 15 maybe with the spiral. It's there's plenty of space, so it's gone in quite well. Washing up liquid, I think, really helped with the water. Just to give that a little lubrication to go through, because it's a bit pipe sticky. So what I've got to do now is find something to roll it around. It's 10 metres, so we need to make it obviously curl it up. I'm thinking I've got a very old fermentation vessel. Right, so what we're doing now is wrapping the whole thing around this. So we've got it something soft as well, so we don't scratch the hose. So I'll just have a check round it, and then I'll try and loosen it just to take it off. And then what I'm going to do is use some cable ties. Probably cable tie 2 at a time together. Work up maybe in 3 places. Getting there. Okay, doesn't seem too bad to get off actually.